Welcome to Refrigeration and Air Conditioning Lecture Series. Today we see about the duct design. So duct design means to find the dimension of duct. So let us see the diagram. Here is a fan and these are the locations where air is to be passed. So these are the ducts AB, BC, CF, CE and DB which can be used. So in air conditioning distribution system, Q and V of air is maximum at blower outlet. It goes on reducing to the subsequent section. So duct should carry necessary volume of air to the space with minimum friction loss. Here we need use of friction chart. So already we have discussed about friction chart in last video. There are three methods of duct design. We will see one by one. Equal friction method. In this, pressure drop per unit length of duct is maintained same. So dampers at each outlet of duct is required for balancing the same pressure drop. We will see one example on this. So in this example, we are given duct AB, BC and BD, 30 meter, 30 meter, 10. These are the values of discharge at the end. Meter cube per minute, D and C. So we use here tabulated form. First column section AB, BC, BD. Discharge in first duct will be what? Summation of discharge at C and D end. That is 480 cm. We need in meter cube per second. Then respect to discharge in BC and BD in meter cube per second we calculate. In first duct, main duct, velocity is given, that we take in meter per second. Now these are the remaining values that we have to calculate, red color. So we start with the help of friction chart. From the friction chart, for the main duct Q value and velocity value combination, we get PF and diameter. Then for BC, we know PF value, that as per the method, we write everywhere as the same. Now we have 0.1 and a discharge in respect to duct. By using this, we get for BC discharge, for the BC duct, diameter and velocity. Similarly for section BD, PF value and respect to discharge from friction chart, we get diameter and velocity. Now, maximum pressure drop in a system is a product of PF and maximum length. So here, maximum length is what? 30 plus 10 is 40 meter and 30 plus 30 is 60 meter. So 30 plus 30 is 60 meter is maximum length. We take for the calculation and we calculate maximum pressure drop in system. Second method is velocity reduction method, where duct is designed with decreasing velocity. So here we will take same problem statement. In section AB, we know discharge. From friction chart, velocity and discharge, we get diameter and PF. Now in second section, we assume velocity in decreasing manner. So in second section, we assume velocity 9. And third section, we assume velocity 8. So we obtain for the value of this velocity and corresponding discharge, PF and diameters. Similarly, we obtain for this velocity and discharge, PF and diameter from friction chart. The third method is static regain method. This method ensures that at the end of each section, the static pressure is same. So PS is static pressure, PS, same. So how it is possible? It is possible if the friction loss, that is PF, in each branch is made equal to gain in pressure. A gain in pressure is what? SPR, means static pressure regain. Static pressure regain has formula R multiplied by PV1 minus PV2, which is what? Reduction in velocity, dynamic velocity. Let us see numerical. In the numerical, we are given friction loss in different branches 1.2 meter mm, static pressure at end 5 mm of water. Velocity in main duct and diameter main duct is given. Static regain factor is given. So let us see from the sketch. In a duct AB, Q1 pi by 4 D1 square into V1. So diameter and velocity for main duct is given. So we can calculate Q1. Now this Q1 discharge is divided into three parts equally. So we get at the each end Q1 dash, Q2 dash, Q3 dash discharge is what? Main discharge divided by 3, that is 3.77 meter per second. Then in the main duct, dynamic pressure PV1 we calculate by using this formula. Now we go for the next duct CD, where Q2 we can obtain now by subtracting Q1 dash value, this value from the Q1 is 11.32. So we get Q2. So this Q2 value we use to find the diameter. So for that V2 is required. This V2 we obtain from this SPR is equal to this formula. SPR are given, dynamic pressure one duct is given, PV2 we get. From PV2, from the formula we get velocity. So this velocity and this discharge in 2 means CD duct, we get diameter of duct CD. Then duct EF, Q3 discharge here will be what? Subtraction of discharge CD duct minus this Q2 dash. So Q2 dash is 3.77. So in EF duct we get discharge. Then from SPR problem, SPR formula, we get dynamic pressure in third duct. From this we get velocity in third duct. Then third duct velocity and third duct discharge, we get diameter of third. So in this way we get the diameters in all ducts. Now pressure at each point of change we write B, C, D, E, F. These are the change points B, C, D, E, F. So at B point, then D point and F point, as per the given PS value is the same 4, 4, 4. So at C, pressure will be what? 4 plus 1.2, that is PF value 5.2. So C and E we will have same value. Then PV value at B point we calculated. Now in CD duct and in EF duct, PV values are same. So PV value CD here and PV value for EF duct. Total pressure in respective point is what? Summation of PS and PV. Now to calculate fan power, we take maximum value of PT, multiply that in Pascal because we get this value in mm, multiplied by Qmax, maximum discharge, in Watt we get fan power maximum. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe and share.